into the long Mississippi I was born. With mama's prayers and daddy's love, I carried on to become the king of rock and roll. The whole world knew me by my song. I'm alive and free. You know me. Some say I live, some say I die. Some can't count the tears they've cried. I'm alive and free. Yes, you know me. And through it all, I still talk.
They discovered something startling.
All three samples appear to be from different individuals because each one of them has a different DNA type.
Elvis's liver tissue sample is different than Elvis's autopsy tissue sample, and neither matches Jesse.
It's over.
Or so we thought.
The next hearing has not been scheduled, and I just got off the phone with the DNA specialist out of Arizona. He says he believes Eliza is Elvis's half-sister and that Elvis is still alive. He says the proof is there. DNA evidence doesn't lie. In the studio, Lauren Lee, Fox 13 News.
To bring you this report tonight, but our viewers wanted it, we wanted it, so here it is. 25 years after his death, is Elvis Presley ready to make the comeback of all time? Well, a doctor who claims he's treating the king says yes, but we wanted scientific proof and so did you. So tonight, the long-awaited DNA test results are in. He claims he's Elvis Presley, still alive in 2002. We wanted scientific proof. He gave us his DNA. The mystery began 7 months ago when Kansas City doctor Donald Hinton stepped forward claiming Elvis Presley was his patient. He said Elvis faked his death and was living as his deceased twin brother Jesse. Hinton published this book containing letters allegedly written by Elvis, now Jesse, and this picture, supposedly Elvis today.
It is absolutely Elvis Aaron Presley. This is not a trick, this is not a hoax, it's just the absolute truth.
If you're treating a patient, there has to be a medical record. For the first time, Dr. Hinton is sharing with us this medical file.
Visits with the patient and telephone contact with the patient.
With Jesse's permission, we reviewed the medical record, which documents 5.5 years of treatment. Jesse suffers from depression, chronic pain, and yes, he insists he's Elvis Presley.
They ask, why is he doing it now? And it is for spiritual reasons. It's not to come back and make money. It's all for what this individual wants to do for his soul.
Each and every day becomes more stressful. He can't just come out. If he could have done that, he'd have done that years ago.
Linda Felix Johnson's another friend allegedly protecting the king. If Jesse isn't motivated by money, what's their motivation? The publisher confirmed neither Linda or Dr. Hinton have made any money off their book.
I want his safety. These people don't understand. This is a true story. This is real.
He is in the United States. He is in different places at different times. He is making his plans based on his spiritual beliefs.
Having heard the claims before, we wanted to meet Jesse in person. He said not yet, so we sent him a police DNA test kit and fingerprint cards. The DNA saliva swab came back first and was collected by forensic scientist Tony Tambasco.
The swab was extracted. It was found to contain a large amount of DNA. The DNA is in fact from a male.
Next, we took envelopes from the letters allegedly written by Elvis to Dr. Hinton. Unbeknownst to the doctor, we had them tested for DNA.
16, 16, 16, 6, 7, 6, 7, 6, 7, and so on down the line.
The DNA on the envelopes matched the DNA from the cheek swab.
There would be a complete profile that we would be able to attribute to a single individual.
We needed something confirmed as Elvis Presley's to compare DNA, like this sweaty scarf certified and autographed by the king.
really came up with no DNA that was worth anything at all.
The DNA was too degraded.
DNA, as it leaves the body, will maintain its integrity for a long time, but yeah, it will break down.
Recently, there's been a lot of talk about Elvis's hair. In fact, a big jar of it was auctioned off for more than $100,000. A private collector in Cleveland said we could use his hair sample for DNA testing, but whether it's this sample or that jar, none of it is suitable because it's all cut hair.
Without the root, the only thing we could really do with the DNA would be called mitochondrial DNA. The thing we would need to compare that mitochondrial DNA would be his mother, because his mother would have passed that DNA to him.
But Elvis would pass his DNA to his child. A spokesperson for Lisa Marie Presley refused our request for DNA.
Did you know Elvis?
Yeah, I knew Elvis.
He's not a relative, but Nashville entertainer Jimmy Velvet was a close friend.
Faking his death situation was a rumor from the beginning, so of course, if he loved Elvis, you would have hoped that was the case rather than him being dead. I wanted to believe that, but I never did.
Jimmy let us test items from a Presley hospital visit December 20th, 1967.
He threw a fit at Graceland one time because the car wouldn't start, and he jumped up on the hood and kicked his foot through the windshield and cut his leg.
We sent part of a blood stain to the lab.
That stain analysis failed to give us a complete profile. The DNA is from a man and a woman.
A man and a woman, but neither matches Jesse's DNA profile.
Where that DNA came from on the genes is anybody's guess. It could simply be that stain, as well as any contact with it for however it's been stored over the last 35 years.
Fingerprints from Jesse were smeared, and portions that were readable didn't match this Elvis fingerprint card from 1970. Finally, we learned of a Memphis doctor with copies of Elvis's medical records and even tissue samples. Bill Beeney met the doctor in 1996 and convinced him to have the tissue samples tested for DNA.
Doctor was a super nice fellow. He asked that his name be kept out of it because he has a large clinic in Memphis. He didn't want any controversy that involved him.
The doctor inherited the medical records and tissue samples from his friend, pathologist Dr. Harold Sexton. Sexton had handled two liver biopsies for Elvis when he was tested for hepatitis in 73 and 75. Sexton also worked on the autopsy tissues.
To protect himself, Dr. Sexton kept copies of everything he did.
For fear of being sued, Sexton saved the tissue slides from both the biopsies and the autopsy.
So I said, how do we know these are Elvis samples? The doctor went to the medical records, which have the heading of the Baptist Hospital on them.
The tissue slides are clearly documented in the medical records. The doctor agreed to release them for DNA testing. We wondered if either sample would match Jesse's DNA.
We did the tests on Jesse, and our results turned out to be a different type than liver or the autopsy samples. That means that they have come from a different individual.
Not only was Jesse's DNA different, but researcher Alice Newman found something startling.
I got a different DNA type from the 1975 biopsy sample and the autopsy specimen. All three samples appear to be from different individuals because each one of them has a different DNA type.
Elvis's liver tissue is different than Elvis's autopsy tissue. Bill Beeney's not surprised. His lab ran the original tests with the same results.
The only conclusion I could come to is that Jesse is not Elvis Presley. Elvis is still out there somewhere.
But Dr. Donald Hinton is standing by his story.
He has not indicated to myself or any of his other friends that he does not intend to follow through with his plan to prove himself by the end of the year to let the world know that he is still here.
What happens if January 1st comes and there's still no Elvis?
If nothing happens, it would be because it was prevented from happening.
Elvis has left the building.
Okay, so how could there possibly be three different sets of DNA? That is a question we have now put to the Tennessee Attorney General's office and the Shelby County District Attorney. Both say they are looking into our findings. As for Dr. Hinton, we feel that we've given him every opportunity to prove his story, and he still does stand by his story. The only real proof, of course, is for Jesse to come forward and prove it if he is Elvis, or if Lisa Marie would provide us with her DNA. We will keep you posted as the saga now continues.
You have more of a mystery now than you did when you started. Where in the world do you go from here?
We go to Tennessee. We need to find out what exactly is going on with those two sets of tissue samples. We need to know. So we're going to keep pursuing this, keep investigating.
This is very confusing indeed. And it'd be interesting to find out what you think right now, quickly.
Quickly, we were looking for a clear-cut answer. Our viewers were looking for, and the Pandora's box just opened wide.
Wow, we look forward to
Thanks,
it.
Thanks,
Susan. It's really something.
Thank you, Suzanne.
The Tennessee Attorney General's Office and the Shelby County District Attorney both say they are looking into it because, at a minimum, the autopsy tissue should match the liver biopsy tissue, and they don't match. And of course, Jesse doesn't match either one either.
So does that mean now the question is, where is he, or who's in the grave, or what?
That's the question. That's
you
a very good question. That is the question.
But nothing matched Jesse's. We have anything
at
that
this
we
point,
believe
no.
that matched this guy.
At this point, that's correct. And we feel like we've given Dr. Hinton time to prove this. He says Jesse will prove himself, so we're waiting. If you know, we need Lisa Marie, we need Jesse, or we need Graceland to cooperate. Those are the three things we're looking for right now.
Well, if Jesse is coming back before January 1st, he's got about a month, so
time's ticking.
Well, thank you, Suzanne.
You're
very
welcome.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Beanie and the doctor arrived at a startling conclusion.
I can't argue with science. Elvis was not in the casket.
Beanie's friends formed the Presley Commission. They took their evidence to Memphis and tried to get the case reopened. Both the local police and Tennessee Attorney General's office refused. Lisa Marie also respectfully refused our request for DNA. And a spokesperson from Elvis Presley Enterprises writes, "The book is so completely ridiculous that we will not dignify it with participation in your story. But thank you for offering us the opportunity."
If Elvis is out there and had reasons for doing what he did, then that truth should be known. If it was a fact that Elvis Presley died, then that truth should be known.
The Missouri Attorney General's
ability to prescribe medication, some have said maybe it was a drug ring. Well, the DEA investigated that and did not find that to be the case. As for Memphis, well, we also tried to get authorities there to investigate the mismatched DNA, but they refused. And as for Jesse, well, as you know, we are trying to track him down. We'd like to talk to him, and there are some authorities out there who would like to talk to him, too.
And maybe one day it'll happen.
Yeah. Let's hope. One day soon.
All right. Thank you for that.